एवरीवन, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन. आई एम ए सब्जेक्ट टीचर ऑफ सोशल स्टडी एंड इन आवर लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द चैप्टर नंबर 12 एंड चैप्टर नेम इज चेंजिंग मीन्स ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन. नाउ लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द चेंजिंग मीन्स ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन एंड in this video we are going to discuss about the question answer of chapter 12. And now last video we have discussed about the first two exercise, and in this video we are going to discuss about the third exercise, that is answer the following question in one or two sentence. So student, first of all, let's have a quick overview on the communication and the types of communication. What is communication? Communication means to exchange message or information, and all living things communicate in different ways. All living things can communicate in different ways, like they can speak and they can communicate by gesture, facial expression, etc. And there are two types of communication. First one is personal communication and second one is mass communication. So first of all, I am going to discuss about personal communication. Personal communication takes place directly between two or more people. Speaking face to face is often the best way to communicate. And later, partial, telegraph, telephone, mobile phone, smartphone, computer, internet, and social networking site are the form of personal communication. Now look at the mass communication. Mass communication refers to the transmission of information to a large number of people at the same time. To an enormous number of people at the same time. Like, mass communication takes place with the help of mass media and social media. Newspaper, magazines, radio, television, cinema are the form of mass media. So student, now come on the exercises. Exercise 3. Answer the following question in one or two sentence. So student, in this exercise, you have to give answer according to the given question, and you have to give answer in one or two sentence. Now look at the question first. What is the meaning of communication? What is the meaning of communication? Communication is the process of expressing one thought and ideas to other in different way. This is the meaning of communication. Now look at next question. What is a smartphone? Smartphone are mobile phone that can be used to make phone calls, send and receive emails, listen to music, and to take photographs and share them as a smartphone. And we can use a smartphone while traveling also. Now look at the next. That is third number. What is the advantages of the radio over newspaper as a means of mass communication? Radio provide information to people who are visually challenged, who cannot see or who cannot read, who are illiterate, is the advantage of radio over the newspaper. So students, radio is very useful for the person who cannot see and who cannot read. Now look at the next question. And this is the last question. Classify the different type of communication about which you read in this chapter under the following heads: listening, reading, writing, audiovisual. So student, I have explained you in your earlier video that communication is divided into two parts, that is personal and mass communication. So student, look at this. Look at this. And all these are divided into keep into following, you have to keep this words into the following heads, that is personal communication and mass communication. So first of all, this is the listening. You can listen by radio. You can listen by radio. So it comes in mass communication. It is the mass media. So you have to write the listening under mass communication. Next is reading. Student, you have to read newspaper. You have to read newspaper. So, and newspaper provide information to a large number of people at the same time. So newspaper comes in mass communication. So you have to write reading in the mass communication. Next one is writing. Here, writing a letter, a form of personal communication, because the communication takes place between the two or more people. So writing comes under personal communication. Look at this. Now next is audiovisual. Audiovisual can be done by the help of television, because television is both an audio and visual means of communication, and it comes in mass communication, because television provide information to a large number of people at the same time. So it comes under mass communication. So you have to write audiovisual under mass communication. Look at this. Here audiovisual is already written under mass communication. So student, I hope you all understand about this question answer, and you have to write this question answer in your CW copy. You have to complete this question answer in your CW copy. That's all, and thank you.